We're looking at Alberto Giacometti's The Palace at 4 a.m. We're in the Museum of Modern Art. You know, it's really interesting. There's all this verticality in Giacometti's work after the war and a lot of horizontality in Giacometti's work early.
Although I sense the same sense of fragility and tenuousness here in the structures of this house that seems to be outlined kind of with sticks.
That's true, and they're very delicate sticks, and they're not especially well wrought.
No.
You know, it seems like a sort of a weekend project kind of thing.
It does. A child would make, yeah, almost.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, there's a very wonderful kind of childlike quality, mm-hmm, here, but also a kind of stage-like quality. As if what's taking place is sort of enacted before us. So the palace at 4 a.m., and clearly what Giacometti is talking about is the unconscious. His dream.
And so we have a female figure in the left.
Almost a little chess piece.
Standing very vertically and
very proper. Very erect. And very much a kind of presence.
Super ego, perhaps, suggesting what one should do. And then also having that kind of super ego feeling, I think, is that phallic shape.
Oh, see, I saw that as the id.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I saw the id as the dinosaur bird figure
the
in the upper right. Yeah, and also that embryonic spine that seems to be in a kind of cage
in the lower right.
I
mean, it's almost as if we're in a museum of natural history. And I think it's important to remember that psychoanalysis at this time was being seen by the surrealists in France really secondhand as linked to this idea of a kind of primordial past, as somehow the unconscious being linked to some ancient truth.
Some truth about the human species, about our...
About our most sort of fundamental desires.
Instincts, yeah, and desires.
And so here we have then this stage where every night Giacometti's unconscious in a sense enacts itself for perhaps,
mm-hmm,
hours.
But it's all held together with string and glue, and maybe that's a good representation of the unconscious mind.
I think so. And its mutability, its flexibility, that it's rebuilt every night perhaps.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, absolutely.